We begin tonight, though, with a still-developing story, a major coronavirus outbreak at an isolation hotel housing foreign fishermen. The Sudima Hotel in Christchurch is in lockdown after 11 people tested positive for COVID-19, with another 14 cases under investigation. They're all imported cases detected during routine day three testing. For the very latest, let's go live to Lisa Davies outside the Sudima Hotel. Lisa.
Well, the hotel was notified this afternoon by the Ministry of Health about this large number of cases. And epidemiologist Michael Baker says it is highly unusual for there to be so many in one facility. But I spoke to hotel management. They say although obviously a big group like this with the virus is of concern to their staff, it really is business as usual for them because they always operate with the utmost care and have no contact with anyone who is in quarantine.
A hotel under lockdown. Behind these windows, 11 confirmed COVID sufferers and 14 more who are suspected to have the virus.
It's very unusual to have this number of cases in one facility at the same time. But to put this in context, this isn't that different from the number of cases we might have spread over 1 or 2 weeks.
They are part of a large group of fishery workers who arrived on a flight from Russia and the Ukraine, collectively paid for by Independent Fisheries, Sea Lord and Maruha Nichiro. Independent Fisheries says the first flight arrived on Friday morning with hundreds of fishermen on board. About 240 are now in isolation at the Sudima in Christchurch.
Our first worry is always going to be, you know, are any of our fishermen affected by what's occurred? Making sure that they are being managed appropriately and that their health, of course, is being taken care of.
The government allowed border exemptions for trained fishing crew to travel to New Zealand as critical workers. Michael Baker says although the positive cases are low risk to the public, every case that lands here increases the chance of it getting out.
We need to look very systematically at how to reduce that risk. And one of the options to think about, of course, is a greater emphasis on pre-travel quarantine and testing.
Of course, for staff at the hotel, safety is paramount.
They don't come into contact, and that's very clear, with the people staying in the facilities. But where you can catch it off a lift, a button, a surface, that's pretty scary if you're a worker.
However, the Ministry of Health says strict infection, prevention and control processes are followed to minimise the risk to public and staff.
All right, back to Lisa now. A minimal risk to the public, according to officials. What else do we know about this outbreak, Lisa?
Well, we've been told that the people who've tested positive will be moved into a special quarantine area within this same facility. That's standard procedure here in Christchurch. Over the next 2 weeks, another large group of fishermen will fly to our country. The Ministry of Health says in this case and in the next case, this just shows that border controls are operating as they should.
Kia ora, Lisa. In Christchurch, Lisa Davies.